There are 82 churches in Uganda under our ministry. And God called me when I was 14 years old. And most of you know, if you have heard about Idi Amin in Uganda, who killed a lot of people, didn't want them to talk about Jesus. And we decided, and our grandfathers decided to go under the cave for prayers. And people prayed, and God changed Uganda. Today, we are enjoying the revival in Uganda because of prayer. I believe in the power of prayer. I came with my daughter. She has a baby. She's sitting at the back. We have just moved here in Arunda, and we've been looking for a church, a place of fellowship. And I've enjoyed this type of worship. How many of you know that it's just the color, but we are the same? And it's just the color. We are the same because you are my sisters and brothers. Even if when we die, we will go together in heaven. And the most important thing is that one day all of us are going to meet in heaven, and we will celebrate one God. Amen?
Amen.
So as I told you that I'm coming from Uganda, Uganda came from a very tough time during the war. We had a lot of war in Uganda during the fight of Idi Amin, Obote, and the current president now, who has been in power for more than 30 years. It's coming to 30 years. But one of the important things, God has helped us. Every fruit we can celebrate today, it is coming from prayer. That God heard our prayers, and God answered our prayers. Today, in our constitution, the constitution of Uganda, we have a freedom of worship, which was not there like before. Today, the cabinet, the parliament, they come together to worship God. Every year, we come together to dedicate the land in the hands of God, which was not there before. But it is because of prayer. And one thing I want to encourage you, brothers and sisters, never stop to pray. You can be tired of other things, but don't be tired of prayer. We can see that we are enjoying life in this country. Whatever you are enjoying, don't forget prayers, because it is the key of life. Amen?
Amen.
So today in Uganda, we celebrate the victory of Jesus Christ because of prayer. And I was shot in my two legs. I could not walk before, but I'm walking today because of God. None of my people would think that I can walk again, because my two legs, they were shot during the war, and I could not walk. I could not do anything. I was just lowering down. But after prayer, one man of God came and prayed for me. Now I'm walking. So I give the glory to God. We have seen a lot of things God is doing. Both of my parents died on the same day. They were shot during the war. And when the current president came in power, God told me to start a church in my home village. And God told me to invite all the people together and ask them to forgive one another for what happened. You know, my parents, they were killed during the war in the community, and they slaughtered them like snakes. And it was very hard for me to grow up or to live in a community knowing that some of the people you're living with, they're the people who killed your parents. But God told me to declare a forgiveness, to forgive the community, and cook for them a meal, and call everyone to come and forgive one another. So I did that. In my home village where I'm coming from, I planted a church there. And I gave them a boa hall. I cooked a meal for one day. And I called them for reconciliation. And I declared that as a son who lost his father and his mother the same day, I forgive all of you. And it was so wonderful. People didn't know that we can do such a thing. But forgiving is a weapon. Since when I declared that forgiveness in my community, in my own village, today there is peace in my community. There is peace, there is forgiveness, there is grace in that area. When you come in that area, you can sense the peace of God in that area. Though it was very hard for me to think about and to know that such people you're living with, they kill your parents. You have no father, you have no grandmother, you have nobody. But because of the grace of God, I declare that forgiveness and my community is moving on. So we give the glory to God, and I want to thank you, all of you, for believing in God. And I want to encourage you, the only place where we can hide ourselves is in God. The only place where we can be safe in life, it is God. I know the system can create an opportunity for us to be safe. I know the government, they can do a lot of things for us to feel like we are safe. But it is only God where we can hide ourselves and feel secure. I know friends, they can tell us how much they love us. People, they can tell us how beautiful we are. People, they can tell us how wonderful we are. They can promise a lot of things for us. But the only man who can never change, the man I know, who delivered my life, who changed my heart, who washed the tear in my heart, the tear I had before, after losing my parents. As a young boy, losing your parents on the same day, and you are shot your two legs, you cannot walk, you cannot do anything, you cannot go in any hospital, and you see the people in the whole community, they're having their parents, and so you have none. And it was only God who gave me the grace. And I encourage you to love your God. The only grace we ever can hide. Thank you, Pastor, for the great work you're doing, and all the leaders of the church. Thank you so much. I love the music. Thank you, brother. You made my day. I love the way you play that music. I was watching you. I've never been in such a service. You know, I don't hear the language, but spiritually we connect. I feel the connection in the spirit. And I love the way you play the music. Thank you so much. You blessed my heart. Thank you so much. I have friends in America. I've been to one of the churches in America. They are coming from, they speak Espanol. And I've been to their church. They play that kind of music, but yours is very different. The way you do that, I love it. I love it. Thank you so much. Thank you, Pastor, and thank you, everyone. I'll be coming here because I love the music and the worship, and to see my sisters and brothers in different color and the way you worship God. This is my family. Thank you so much.